Okay, so we're going to progress on to the floor joist system. This is for the grade 12 class. So what you're going to do is you are going to start out by creating this pocket on center on each of the walls of your basement that you've created. And you're going to basically look at, it's got a 6x4 dimension and it goes down 9.5. So let's, this is what you should have. So what I would do is I would go here and let's find our midpoint. And I'm going to go 3 inches. Okay. Okay, let's do it this way. So if it's 6, it's going to be 3 inches each way. And like so. This is not the most efficient way to do it. Okay. And let's just get rid of that. Push that down. The dimension was 9. And, 9.5. Okay. So 9.5 inches. Okie doke. I would add a layer right now. I'm going to go foundation dimensions. Okay. Let's quickly go tools just to kind of confirm all our stuff is copacetic. Like so. And there you go. Fantastic. The only problem is, you may recall, you've got to check that off to be actually drawing inside that particular layer. So in the event you do that, you just go identity info, and it says foundation walls, and we're going to change that to foundation dimensions. Same with this. Let's change that to foundation dimensions. And this as well. Now this is going to be something probably that you're going to end up doing a few times throughout this exercise. And I'm just going to turn that off, get rid of that. And we're going to do the same thing over here. What we are going to do is we're going to quickly measure. That's 11 feet 9 inches. Because we have the window here, that's not going to allow us to just use our midpoint. So 11 feet 9 inches. Okay. And let's. Okay. So let's go 4 inches. 6 inches. Okay. And the other one I used a fraction. What I'm going to do is, if you want, you can use decimal as well. So you can type in 9.5 inches. And you'll get the same, essentially the same thing. So one thing we can do is we can take this. Pull that out, except we'd have to redo all that stuff in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and I'm going to use my rectangle. I'm going to scroll out. this is going to be for our beam. Go click like so. And because we pushed it down like that, we're going to have to fill that in once again. And there you go, we've got our beam. So we're going to... Now it wants you to basically create four different boards in there. And that's because there actually is no such thing as a board that size. So all you want to do... Oops. You want to make sure that you're using the pencil. Midpoint, and then you're going to go the new midpoint, to the new midpoint, and the same thing over here, we're going to do that too. Okay. Instructions. Okay. So now we're going to transition to creating the floor system. So what you're going to have to do is we're going to have to do a 3.5 by 1.5, and we're going to put that down on the floor, and that's going to basically surround the entire inside portion of our foundation. Okay, so we're going to go in here, we're going to go three and a half. Okay. Now let's just move this to make sure that our line was created on the right axis, and it was not. See that? So we want that line to go straight up. Just like so. So 1.5. Okay. Go like this. We're going to have to push this over. Same thing over here. That. Okay. And okay. Now you could make these components and just copy them over. I should have probably prefaced the assignment with that. It may or may not save time. This is just a pretty quick draw. Some of you might realize that this particular version of SketchUp doesn't look like yours. The reason being is I'm using a 2016 edition. So there might be some very minor nuanced differences, but it's essentially the same. Okay, so that's the end of part one for the beam assignment. Part two will follow. Okay, this is part two of the grade 12 floor joist system for the first floor. Okay, so we're looking at basically the corner here, and this is the corner that you're looking at on your drawing. And what we're going to do is we're going to create what's called a 2x10, which is actually 1.5 by 9.5. And we're going to make sure that we overlap. Now we've labeled what these boards are called. Obviously, it's the overlap board, and it's also going to sit on top of the mud sill, which is those boards that we've already created. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get this, and I'm going to go 1.5 inches. Okay, I'm going to get my rectangle tool out. Okay, and I'm going to push that all the way to the end. Okay, let's find that end board there. Okay, and I see this is going to be in the need of being filled in. Okay. Now what we're going to do is we're going to do the same thing over here. Let's just go straight up 9.5. Let's push this, not that way, but okay, so let's complete this. Okay, let's go 1.5. Okay, we're going to do that. Let's go over here. That over as well. Okay, so that's going to be the outside frame, more or less. Okay, now this is really important. I really want to point this out, and I hope everyone notices. So this board is sitting right flush with that interior wall. You don't want this hanging over. That's definitely not something you want to see. Okay? And you're also going to notice that there's a lip here left over. And that's something that's really important, because you're going to want these joist boards that we create for the floor to sit on top of that lip. Otherwise, they'd just be hanging off the side, and that's not something that would be actually able to sustain that load. Okay? So let's go over to our instructions. And we're going to draw joist boards that span the frame space 16 inches or 1 foot 4 inches. Okay. Now we're going to draw the floor 1 inch thick, and that's going to represent some plywood. And that's going to be the end of that assignment. So what we're going to do is we're going to draw joists that are 16 inches apart. Okay. So we're going to draw the first one, and it's going to be 16 inches apart. 16 inches. Okay, so it's going to be from this first corner to that corner there, and I'm going to go down. Okay, click. That's 1.5 wide, and I am going to attempt to make this into a component. I can all but guarantee it's going to include, you know what I'm going to do? Actually, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to measure from here to here. 24 feet 4 inches. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to construct it out here. 24 feet 4 inches. And I'm going to go 9.5. Wide, and okay, so let's just push this to the end. Or we could just type in 24 feet 4 inches. Okay, so that's going to be our board right there. And we're going to make this into a component. Perfect. Okay, so I'm going to leave this one right here. Okay, and I'm going to grab it by that top corner. And since we already had a little bit of a marking there, okay, perfect. So that spacing is going to be perfect. And here's what I'm going to do now is I'm going to hold the control key. I'm going to start moving it, then I'm going to let go. I'm going to type in 16 inches, and I am going to keep doing that. And what I'm going to do though is I'm going to end up with a bit of an oddball at the end. Click. Now see what SketchUp did right there? I don't know if you saw. I'm going to go, see, on edge, 1 foot, 4 inches. That's 16 inches. So SketchUp knows what we're doing. So I'm going to just keep doing that. Click. Now you could sit down and do the math, and you could array this. Depending on your math skills, it might be quicker to do it this way. you get to the end there, you're going to notice a space that's inconsistent. And this is what I like to call the oddball board, because unless you have somebody who basically engineers everything to be perfect in terms of spacing, you're not going to end up with perfectly spaced stuff. So that's just not realistic. So I think the end of the operations also specified that we're going to make the floor, going to make it 1 inch thick. The easiest way to do that is we're going to throw up a rectangle over here. And let's do that. Okay, like so. And then we're going to push. Oops. Thought I could get it from that distance, but I can't. Okay. So we're going to push this over the top. And there we go. That's our Joist system with the floor.